days and nights. A lady doesn't wander all over the room and blow on some other guy's dice. Let's keep this party polite. Never get out of my sight. Stick with me, baby, I'm the fella you came in with. But be a lady tonight.
What's going on, YouTubers? I want to hit you guys up and say thank you for watching the video, and also thank you for visiting this album. This album is called Card of Fate. This album is dedicated to my second book. Hold on, I have it right here. Card of Fate, Poems of a Gambling Addiction. This book I wrote in my second, going into my third year in college. I think it was in November I wrote this book, I believe. Yeah, November when I finished it. And basically, this book is, of course, it talks about gambling addiction, but it talks about it in a unique way. Throughout my college life, mostly all college students, at some point in time, they get a refund check. Now, this refund check sometimes will be from financial aid or loans, whatever money's left over. They would get a check in the mail from the college. Me, I went to community college. And it wasn't that expensive. So, you know, I got a lot of money back to a point where I was getting, say, $1,000, $2,000 a semester. And given that I didn't live on campus, that money was mine. So I got like a good $2,000, $3,000 back a semester. Now, like every teenager, my money went strictly to clothes, shoes. I woke up early. And like my second year and said, crap, I got to do something constructive. I can't sit here and just start spending this money like crazy. I don't even have food in my fridge, nothing. I got to sit there and actually pay back my loans, you know, actually start being adult, start being a man. Sadly, a lot of my friends didn't wake up until later on. Now, don't get me wrong, though. You know, every teenager goes through that phase when they're on their own, you know, mommy send them money, dad send money, whatever. And mind you, given I went to community college, it was easy for me. Everything was fine. The money poured right in. I didn't even need a job at the time. The crazy thing is, sorry for the pause. I just had to think about it. And to this day, I talk about this like if, you know, because I've witnessed this and I've actually lived through it. My friends lived through it. There was a casino called Turning Stone near my college. And at the time, the casino, they had brand new stuff they were doing. Sitting here promising students if they sign up, they'll get a $100 card to play on the electronic machines, all that good stuff. And believe it or not, my friends ran with it. I ran with them. And we went to the casino. I got my membership card. For fun, I had my first gambling experience and my last gambling experience. I had $150 in my pocket. And I said, you know what? I don't care. Let me spend it. I got money on my card. I got $150 cash on me. Put it on the blackjack table. And woo, my luck was good. I got 21 right there on the money. 21. Now, those of you don't know blackjack, once you get 21, you win. $300 and some change. Now, as soon as I got that money, I didn't want to stay there. I wanted to leave. I said, come on, guys, I'm out. Let's go. I was ready. The girls, the cute ones, came with the trays and everything. You don't want a water or a drink? No, don't talk to me. Get away. I'm fine. Leave me alone. I want to go. My friends didn't take my advice good at all. I told them, whatever money you got, it's a blessing. Let's leave. They didn't take that. To a point where I lost $300. I lost it because, number one, my friends blew out all their money. I mean, it was crazy. And in the book, I conclude that my definition of gambling is a drug. Because once you lose,
you're playing catch-up game. Once you win, quite few people would come back. Some would leave. Out of 100, I would say 5 would sit there and say, well, you know what, I'm leaving with my money. Others would just go right back to the table and see if they got more luck and lose everything. I mean, I had to sit there and pay for gas money, pay for a car for one of my friends. They lost all their money. I actually saw one guy sit here and blow away $1,000 just by playing dice on a crap table. And I'm sitting back, I'm like, that's crazy. Like, didn't you think, you know, like, aren't you thinking? You're sitting here spending all this money, like, aren't you thinking at all? And the main thing that kept on telling me was that I just wanted to get my money back. And it just dawned on me that this is a drug. Gambling's a drug. Because it's like you're getting that high. You win one and you're like, crap, I got like $100. Let me see if I get $200. Boom, got $200. Maybe I can get $400. And you end up losing it. And then you sit there, you want to spend more to get that money back that you lost. You're losing it until you don't have nothing. It was to a point where even when some of my friends left, that the loss was still on their mind to a point where they actually thought they can outdo the casino. They thought that they can win again. So they say, you know what, I'll be going there next week. My luck will be better. And I'm just looking at them like, didn't you guys learn your lesson? Didn't you guys, like, wise up and say, crap, I lost, leave it alone, I'm not doing it again? No, they just want to go back again and again and again. If it gotten so bad that rumors started spreading by my friends, their family, other people, friends of their friends. And it got so chaotic that I had their parents calling me on the phone. Hey, is my daughter all right? Is this person all right? My son okay? And I'm like, yeah, they're fine. They're right here. Come to find out that these kids were lying to their parents saying that I don't have any money. I'm down on hard times. I just bought a book that cost $300 and I had the money for it. They were sitting here lying to their parents so they can get that money and then waste it on the casino. I mean, you don't have food in your fridge, but you're spending it on the crap tables. You're spending it playing poker. And a lot of, and like I said, these are not old seniors. These are not old ladies on a slot machine. These are teenage. These are actually young kids that don't know anything about gambling. Nothing but what they see on TV. And they got taken. And I've seen the effect that it had on their family members, mostly. One thing about this book, and like I said, I'm not a psychiatrist, I'm not a guru, I'm not someone who studied this field. My background is criminal justice. That's what my degree was in, criminal justice. Associate's degree in criminal justice. All I do in this book is give you tales of what I've seen, what I've witnessed, what I've helped people go through. And I've noticed that the one way to cure somebody of an addiction, and it's not all addiction, just for me personally, is to bring that person to the ones that they love and show them what effect that what they're doing is having on the ones they love. That's all that I did for them. And they were cured. They stopped gambling. They stopped. This book not only gives a mirror to how your gambling is affecting you, but how your actions by gambling is affecting the ones that you love.